How's how's that Guinness?
Fantastic. I cannot. I've been giving you kudos to your tap rigging. Laszlo put the tap and all the gauges,
tanks.
The pressure tanks.
What, he set it up
and
for
everything
you?
And set it up in
you
my house.
You know how to set that up?
Yeah. Well, I did it at my house years ago, and then friends started enjoying beer on tap at my place.
Yeah.
Like, can you do that at my crib? But I've never done Guinness before, and it's funny, when you come over to Anthony's house and he's not there, everybody acts like his posse. And so I roll in, and Anthony's just arriving at the airport, and so Danny comes to the door, and he's like, you never been downstairs before, have you? And I was like, no, you know, I've hung out around the pool and stuff like that. And he's like, yeah, it's nice when Anthony's not here, then I can sort of show the place around like it's my own. So then we roll downstairs, he's like, here's the fucking theater, bitch.
It's nice to pretend like it's your own Cribs episode. Like, I just want to film like my own Cribs and then send it to people I used to hate back in the day.
You
should do that.
Here's my theater.
That's funny.
So, and I
talk all gangsta and shit.
Oh, he does. And we go over to Anthony's bar, which is this beautiful piece of custom woodworking that this guy must have spent months building. That is
John Dreyer, who is fantastic.
It looks more expensive than my entire house, this bar. It's got the beautiful glass in the back and all the beautiful woodworking. And so I bring all this equipment in, including this high-pressure tank of nitrogen that you need to have Guinness
now,
on tap.
Now, the difference now, give people the difference between the CO2 tank pressure and the nitrogen pressure. CO2 is for, like, Budweiser and things like that, but Guinness needs nitrogen.
Yeah.
What's the difference in pressure?
The difference in pressure is, like, 1,800 pounds per square inch versus 30.
Yeah, you get 30 pounds off of a regular beer tap. Guinness, it's like 1,800 pounds of pressure. It's like torpedo.
Why?
I don't know why they need so much fucking pressure.
And if you knock the tank over and the top valve hits something, it's a rocket that will literally fly through concrete walls.
Yeah.
It is some spooky shit.
Compressed air, Marty!
So,
Martin, God damn it.
Try it again.
That up.
No, try it again.
Hold on, I got
some. And it's out of here!
Yeah.
Or is it? No, it's off the wall. My mistake. I thought the ball was gone, but apparently not.
Yeah. Damn, it's going for a Chief Brody thing.
So I'm very gingerly hooking this thing up to the Guinness tap, and I grab there's a release valve on the top of the tap, so I can sort of, you know, see what kind of pressure there is inside. I pull this release valve, and Guinness shot like a fucking fire hose all across the back wall of Anthony's beautiful bar, and everybody's face went like frozen place. And then the fear came in because Anthony's on the way back home from the airport, and there's like, he will be very angry. I was like, oh my,
clean it up!
How many people get to live in your house when you're not there?
I don't know.
Dude, it is a fucking...
Laszlo, help me out here.
It is a sitcom. It's like people just walk in the door, and it's like the applause. Hey, it's Fred from Brooklyn. And he comes in, and then they walk out. I'm like, what kind of fucking place are you running here?
I know.
Your neighbors have to think you're dealing drugs, dude. The amount of cars that show up, and people come in.
That's true.
And then wobble out.
At all hours, things are happening. I'm not there, and there's people over the house. And it is pretty, pretty sitcom-ish.
But shortly after I hooked the Guinness up on tap, people were getting so blotto they were dropping their phones in the toilet. Which was
some people dropped their Blackberries in the toilet, Danny,
and still using it.
Now I got a new phone.
You got a new phone? Is that number that comes up now your new number or something?
No. I'm doing the Jimmy tactic of the two phones.
Two?
So
okay.
When one's pissing you off, you could use the other, and then when iPhone pisses you off, you go back to the Blackberry.
Fucking A.
Danny turned me on to something. It was we're drinking Guinness. We go down to the bar. It's like, all right. First of all, he tells me that we're gonna wear the rug out. You're gonna like see the carpeting downstairs get worn out from going down for beers and coming back upstairs.
Because it just so happens that you end up, when you're over at Ant's house, you end up chilling on like those like kitchen island, and that just happens to be where people congregate. So to get, you know, another drink, you have to go down the stairs into the basement.
But why don't you do what the bars do?
Exactly.
And run a line from the basement.
Nah.
Why?
Keep it down in the basement.
Well, then you should run one line up into the kitchen. That's obviously going
to
happen.
Next to the sink.
I bet you midsummer you're going to be sick of going downstairs, and it's going to happen.
No.
And then you run one outside.
Might have to put one in the cabana.
Yeah. So, but Danny represents you like a true posse. He's fucked up. he'd had numerous beers, and I'm trying to get everything hooked up, but I didn't have all the parts for the Bud Light, because you've got two different taps. And yeah. I was like, I'm going to get the Guinness today, but I've got to go, you know, to a welding supply store and get some more compressor regulators and so forth. And Danny's like, what the fuck? And I was like, no, it's just, you know, I'll come over like tomorrow or the next day. He was like, oh, we going to fucking do this now. I'm like, dude, it's fucking 7:30, 8 o'clock on a Thursday night. I was like, there's no welding supply store open that's going to have a fucking seat. So he's like, bullshit. I'm calling fucking Home Depot. And he's standing there right next to me on his iPhone. And he goes, English, motherfucker.
Since when do I talk like that?
Dude, when you're drinking.
Dude, when you drink, you are such a fucking homeboy. And so then he gets the guy on the phone. He's like, give me the motherfucking plumbing department. And he's like, yeah, we need a... What do we need, Laz? We need a CO2 regulator. A CO2 regulator, motherfucker. Do you have it? And then they're like...
You don't remember talking like that, Danny? Danny keeps shaking his head over there.
God, and he's like, fuck you. And he hangs up. He's like, orange apron wearing motherfuckers. I'm calling Lowe's.
I'm like, Lowe's.
Dude, I swear they're not... It's a kind of a specialty item. I don't think they're going to have it.
Yeah, that's not an item you pick up at Home Depot.
But and then as soon as Anthony arrives to the front door, everybody starts stepping in. Look what we did, boss, we set up some new stuff for you.
Ooh, this is nice.
Let me see what you guys did to my house. Nice.
The Guinness and the Jack Daniels was what, like, was completely obliterating that night.
Yeah, I hadn't had that in a while. It was probably...
What, you were double fisting?
Yeah, well, no. I was putting Jack in the Guinness.
Jesus.
I know, like, I poured out a nice Guinness and everything, and Danny goes, you got to put some Jack in that. And I'm like, but I like the taste of Guinness. It's going to fuck it up. He goes, sweetens it up a little bit. So I'm like, you know, I'll give it a try. So I dump a little in there. I'm like, wow, that does taste good. But I could tell you could have one of these. Have one, and that's it. And then Danny's
and
just
then you
like,
drop your phones in the toilet.
Fucking fucked
but
up.
But that's not an Irish car bomb.
And I was going to ask, is that a real drink? I've never heard of that before.
It's kind
of,
I mean, you know, you can do it. People drop shots in like.
I thought it was Jameson, right?
Yeah, it is.
Jameson and Guinness is an Irish car bomb.
Yeah, yeah.
So what's it going to take, Ant? Someone overdosing or someone just dying in the fucking house?
Jimmy was just absorbing this, looking at everyone talking, and just like, what the fuck is going on?
The colonel carrying a girl out with a bleeding nose.
I have Boogie Nights. It's the set of Boogie Nights in my house,
and without the fucking.
Jeez.
The cool thing about dropping my phone in the toilet was that as drunk as I was, I knew that it's already in the toilet. So what am I going to do? Like, whether it's in there for another 8 seconds or not, isn't really going to make much of a difference.
Would you just continue dropping the logs on top of it?
I just continue pissing on my phone.
It really doesn't matter.
It's like, really, what's the difference? It's wet.
That's wild.
Yeah, it's,
and it actually, but you continued to use it.
Yeah, actually,
because I called you and you're like, you were so excited. You're like, yeah, and I was like, what? I've never been this excited to hear from you. It's like, well, my phone was covered in shit. And now it works.
it finally dried out the next day, and like as the day went on, like more and more buttons were starting to work. But I hadn't gotten a phone call yet, so all of a sudden, I feel my phone start going off, and it was Lazo. So I pick up. I'm just like, yes. And he's like, what? I'm like, it works. He's like, why wouldn't it work? I'm like, I dropped my phone in the toilet. It still works.
I learned the hard way when you dump it in a toilet or a puddle. Take that fucking battery out immediately. Did you do that?
Yeah, I did. I went through.
Because if you don't, you fry up.
Can't do it.
You fry it up,
dude. It actually worked. It's the only thing that didn't work was like some of the buttons on the keyboard didn't work, but it was like really key buttons, like you know, like the back button and the trackball, like pressy in button. So
pressy in button.
Pressy in button.
What do you call that?
Stupid pressy in button.